Many of you have passed your final year exams and you have become doctors. Some of you have completed your internship and now you want to prepare for the entrance exam. So guys, you have opened the right video. My name is Dr. Himanshu Gupta and I had secured a rank of 62 in NEET PG 2018. And for the past 3 years, I have mentored thousands of students to help them get a good rank in AIIMS PG and NEET PG. And also, I have been making revision videos, which was helpful in the last month of preparation, as well as to know the topics that a student needs to focus while studying. In this video, I am going to discuss with you the strategy for the NEET PG or the next exam that will be held in the year 2022. I will discuss about the challenges that you will face as an intern or a post-intern. I will tell you the timetable that you need to follow throughout the year, the number of grand tests that you need to give, the number of hours that you need to study. And many students are also asking, sir, what do we have to join? Also, I will tell you how you can utilize Marrow for your preparation. So guys, if you are new here, do subscribe to my channel and follow my Instagram page so that you can stay motivated throughout the year. And if you want to skip any part of the video, you can directly click onto the timestamping that is given in the description below. So let us begin, guys. So guys, during my internship, I did a lot of mistakes. So I did not clear my entrance during the internship, but definitely I learned a lot of things that you can learn from my mistakes and not do them. We become doctors. We have passed the final year exams and we have a lot of euphoria. We are seeing the patients, we are doing some clinical work, and you know, that feeling is just amazing. And the problem is that we get a feeling of satisfaction and we just forget our goals. We forget our goals of giving NEET PG exam and we just do our work and come back home and just relax. So the first problem that I feel with the students is that they cannot see their future. When you are in final year or in third year MBBS, you have this fear in your mind that you have to pass these exams. If you do not pass these exams, you will get a supply. But in the internship, you do not have this fear in your mind. And because salary is coming, you know, the first salary when you start earning for the first time, that is again another euphoria. Okay, you lost track of your life. You are just going in the morning, doing some clerical work. So guys, you need to sit. You need to sit and think about your dream college. You need to think about the dream branch that you need to achieve, that you need to get. You have to understand that during the internship, most of the time you are just doing clerical work. These 8 hours of clerical work is not going to take you anywhere. After 1 year of internship, there will be your own friends, there will be your family, and there will be your seniors who will ask you, what was your rank, what branch you are getting, and only then your eyes will open. Then you will feel bad. Then you will think that we had 1 year and we should have studied in that year. It's okay if you have not studied well during your final year or during third year, but you have this 1 year and try to utilize it very well. The second complaint that I see students giving is that they get tired after the work. Dear interns, dear new doctors, I want to ask you how many hours you are working. You are not working more than 48 hours in a week. You guys are young, you guys have energy. How can you be tired after just working for 6 hours or 8 hours? And mostly we are doing not high level work, we are just doing the routine things. So guys, stop giving this complaint during the internship that I am tired. Your postgraduates, your seniors, have you seen them working? Have you seen your medicine resident, your surgery residents working? They work for more than 100 hours in a week. They are the ones who get tired. You should take inspiration from them. You have to say that if they can work so much, okay, so you are just working half the time as your seniors, like those in medicine or surgery. So you should not get tired by working for 48 hours or even 50 hours. And guys, I want to give you one more tip. What you will do, most of the students, they come back after the internship, they go to their rooms or their home and then they sleep. They will sleep and again get up, eat their food and again sleep and come back again for the internship. You will not be the one who will do this mistake. What you can do after your internship, you just go back and sit down on the table on which you study. You will not go to the bed and you will not open Netflix or anything that you like to watch. Okay, so you will directly go to your table and chair and you will try to relax on that table and chair for half an hour. After relaxing there for half an hour, you can begin your studying. But if you do this mistake ki after the internship you go to the bed and sleep, or you open your Netflix, okay, or you go out with your friends, then your time will be lost. And I want to tell you one more, the third problem that you will face. Okay, so guys, in internship you will form a different kind of bond with your colleagues, and that bond will be deeper as you were forming during your final year or third year MBBS. Because during your internship you are working with your colleagues, you are working with your seniors, and it's good that you are forming good friends during your internship. But beware that you form good friends during your internship. Those who want to clear the NEET PG exam, those who want to do well, okay, there will be many people around you who just want to party because they are getting a salary, okay, and I was also one of them. And you know, if you will be around people like these, you will tend to waste a lot of time. So guys, these are the few things that I wanted to tell you if you have just become an intern. And if you just follow these things, okay, you will definitely save a lot of time. Now guys, coming to the detailed plan. First thing is that you have to complete your syllabus within 6 to 7 months. This is a must thing. So if you are starting your preparation in the month of April, then you have to complete your syllabus by the end of October. This should be your first target. Second important thing is that you have to continuously keep on revising what you are reading. What happens with many of the students is that they are completing their subjects one by one, one by one, one by one. And by the end of October, once they have completed all the subjects, then they have no idea about the subject that they have started in the first place. So you have to continuously keep on revising. And how you will do that, I have made a separate video on this topic and it will be displayed in the cards shown above. You can definitely have a look at it. So how you will continuously keep on revising your subjects. Coming to the third point is that first you will start from your final year subjects, because these are the subjects that you have recently read and you will be comfortable in doing the MCQs of these subjects. In another 3 months, you should keep a target that you will complete these final year subjects. Medicine, surgery, pediatrics and obs gyne, you must have read in detail. So you just focus more on the MCQs part. But the short subjects, radiology, psychiatry, anesthesia, dermatology, these are the subjects which you have not read in much detail. I would advise that you read the theory of these short subjects very well. And after that, you try to attempt their MCQs. And doing the final year properly will give you an advantage over the clinical questions as well. So give another three months to your final year, complete all the MCQs, and then you can begin with your third year subjects. You give at least 20 days to third year subjects, then 35 days each to the first year and second year subjects. So this is how you will divide your time for the another 6 months. You can always try to make your own schedule. If you cannot make your own schedule, then this is the one that you can follow. Coming to the third question, how many hours should I study each day, sir? Guys, there is no number that I can tell you that study these many hours and you will get this much and this much rank. What you can do, you can always increase your study hours each day. If you start from 1 hour each day, you can obviously increment your time 10 minutes each day to reach at least 6 hours each day. So you have to try reaching this limit of 6 hours each day, and definitely if you reach there, you will be covering a lot many things. And during your internship, there will be times when your internship will be hectic, like your medicine postings, your surgery postings. So at those times, even if you are not able to study more, just be happy with whatever you are studying. If you are getting just 2 or 3 hours, okay, then study for 2 or 3 hours. Don't take too much stress at that time ki yaar meri to padhai nahi ho rahi, theek hai, meri to padhai kam ho rahi hai. So in those postings, just relax a bit, okay. If you are able to study for 2 to 3 hours in that time, that is sufficient. But one thing is very clear, that you have to study each and every day. You cannot miss the studying, not even a single day, if you are preparing for this exam and if you want to get a very good seat. Now guys, coming to the question, which online application should I join? So guys, instead of focusing which online application is good, I will tell you that all the applications, all the institutes are very good. All the teachers work really hard. So our aim should be that if we have joined one particular institute, we have to complete that application. We have to complete the question bank. And if you want to know one name from me, okay, I would advise that you can go for Marrow. It has a very extensive question bank. That is why I'm advising Marrow to you guys. And I have seen that 90% students go for the Marrow Q bank. So you have to do that thing that everyone is doing. You cannot skip that thing which everyone is doing. So that is one main reason that I am advising you. And also its question bank is really extensive. So some people have a problem that the things are tough, the things are vast. But I feel that if you are doing tough things, if you are trying to study the things in more detail, then you have the chances of getting better marks. And as far as the videos is concerned, you must have seen a lot of videos in the final year. But if there are some subjects in which you have not seen the videos, then obviously you can have a look at them. And if you want to know in detail ki online Q bank kaise karna hai, how you have to complete the question bank, you know, I will tell you that just focus on doing 100 questions per day or 50 questions per day. This should be your minimum aim. Even if you do 100 questions or 50 questions per day, by the end of the year, you will do at least 30,000 questions. And Marrow Q bank has around 18,000 questions. So you will be able to complete this vast Q bank also if you just keep the target of doing at least 50 to 100 questions per day. And guys, coming to the grand test. So my single advice for the grand test is that once you have completed at least 10 subjects, then you can start giving your grand test. You can start giving the grand test after every 15 days for the first 4 months. Okay. And after that, you can keep on increasing your frequency, and you can always stay in touch with my channel, in which I release like strategy videos for the last 3 months, for the last 6 months. So you won't have to worry about ki kitne grand test we have to solve. Okay. I always keep on talking about these things. At last, guys, I want to tell you that if you have to get a good rank, if you want to get the college of your choice, the only success principle is that you have to stay consistent in your studies. No matter what happens, you cannot give any excuses. You will have to make sacrifices of your friends, of the parties, and of all the unnecessary things that people waste their time in. And only then you will be able to do well in the final exam. And guys, also I have been sending weekly mails to my students. If you want to receive weekly mails from me, you can register in the link that is given in the description below. So guys, if you find this video helpful, do give me a thumbs up and do write to me in the comment section if you want me to talk on any other topic. So keep studying guys, and all the best for your preparation.